Welcome to Abhipedia Main's QChat Discussion 2016. The question we'll be discussing today is, Women Empowerment in India Needs Gender Budgeting. What are the requirements and status of gender budgeting in Indian context? So this concept of women empowerment in recent times has been highlighted, which is to throw light upon the condition of plight of women in India, especially labor force participation rate, the opportunity cost of working, rearing a baby, raising a baby. So in this context, Government of India brought about this concept in their gender budgeting issue 2005, and this way they'll be pushing forward the woman empowerment thing. So sir, what is your take on the first part of this question, which says woman empowerment in India needs gender budgeting?
So we have to very briefly explain in this question ki aisa kyun hai ki India mein women empowerment ke liye gender budgeting chahiye. So we have to highlight some facts ki despite 48% of the population being women, unki participation education mein, employment mein and all mein bahut peeche hain wo. Sir aapne abhi kaha ki unka labor force participation rate bahut low hai. They are not empowered basically. Agar hum panchayat raj institutions ki baat kare, parliamentarians ki baat kare, basic cheezon ki baat kare, then women are lagging behind men obviously. So as budget is a political instrument, so we can use that budget to empower women. Right, तो first part के अंदर हम ये थोड़ा सा इसमें briefly introduce कर देंगे कि why is budget a tool to empower women, क्यों चाहिए वो हमें?
Socio-economic upliftment of the women by giving them opportunities to partake in political issues.
By giving them opportunity through the budget.
Through the budget.
Through various schemes, through programs, through various जो भी हम schemes बनाते हैं, उसके through we have to ensure कि women participate करें उसके अंदर.
Okay. And इसका एक और angle आ जाएगा. In order to partake in budget making process, they have to be elected as parliamentarians or municipal councillors or state legislatures. So sir, can you elaborate that as well?
इसी concepts में हम next वाला part answer करने का कोशिश करें कि what is the status and the requirements of gender budgeting. Because gender budgeting as a concept अगर हम देखें, it is not that कि you have to make a separate budget for women. It is not that. It is that while you are formulating the budget, you are formulating any policy. While you are implementing any policy, you are reviewing any policy, you have to have that gender sensitivity in mind. Both men and women. In India case, obviously women, because they are lagging behind. But both men and women. So, that sensitivity ko rakhne ke liye, implementation ke ilawa, formulation mein bhi, aur review ke andar bhi, we will have to involve women. So, aapke wali baat se link hoti hai baat ki participation zaruri hai.
So, reserving seats for women in panchayat elections, municipal elections, and in Lok Sabha is also a good thing.
This can be one of the initiative. Apart from this, there can be NGOs work कर रही हैं, कोई social आपकी आपके self help groups work कर रहे हैं. It can be that also, right? तो gender budgeting में basically हमने इसमें जो second part of the question है, we have to tell also कि India में क्या status है gender budgeting का. So in that we can always say कि gender budgeting को India में बहुत narrow तरीके से देखा गया, right? We are right now focused on कि हमने ये schemes women पे launch कर दी. हमने बेटी बचाओ बेटी पढ़ाओ प्रोग्राम लॉन्च कर दिया, हमने निर्भय फंड बना दिया, बट उसका इम्पैक्ट ऑन द ओवरऑल अपलिफ्टमेंट ऑफ वीमेन क्या हो रहा है, वी आर नॉट फोकस्ड ऑन दैट. आउटकम बेस्ड अप्रोच बहुत कम है. वी आर बेसिकली रिस्ट्रिक्टिंग अवरसेल्व्स टू आउटपुट, नॉट आउटकम्स. तो प्रेजेंट स्टेटस इज वेरी आई मीन टू से कि इतना अच्छा नहीं है जितना होना चाहिए था कॉन्सेप्ट के अकॉर्डिंग. एंड जो रिक्वायरमेंट्स वाला पार्ट
है,
तो रिक्वायरमेंट के लिए अगेन वी विल लिंक इट टू द कॉन्सेप्ट कि जेंडर बजटिंग को अगर हम कह रहे हैं कि हर स्टेज के ऊपर देयर हैज टू बी जेंडर सेंसिटिविटी, तो उस रिक्वायरमेंट को उस बजट को बनाने के लिए द बेसिक रिक्वायरमेंट इज दैट कि वीमेन की पार्टिसिपेशन बहुत जरूरी है, वो एंगल देना बहुत जरूरी है. सेकेंडली डेटा बहुत जरूरी है कि हर चीज़ का, वैन यू डोंट हैव डेटा देन हाउ कैन यू प्रिडिक्ट, हाउ कैन यू प्लान फॉर द फ्यूचर, वैन यू डोंट नो कि हमारे यहाँ डोमेस्टिक वायलेंस केसेस कितने होते हैं, या वीमेन कितनी लैक कर रही हैं, या क्यों लैक कर रही हैं. वी विल हैव टू हैव अ स्ट्रॉन्ग सेट ऑफ डेटा. उस डेटा के बेसिस पर देन वी कैन फॉर्मुलेट पॉलिसीज. सो बेसिकली इन्वॉल्वमेंट ऑफ द वीमेन एंड अ वेरी गुड सेट ऑफ डेटा, ये दो चीज़ें चाहिए ताकि जेंडर बजटिंग जो एक्चुअल कॉन्सेप्ट है, वी कैन रीच दैट लेवल एंड नॉट द लेवल की जस्ट स्कीम्स बना रहे हैं.
एंड सर, व्हाट अबाउट गिविंग प्रॉपर्टी राइट्स टू वुमेन इन इंडिया बाय स्कीम्स सच एज राजीव आवास योजना, इंदिरा आवास योजना? डज गिविंग देम प्रॉपर्टी राइट्स एम्पावर देम एंड एज हाउस होल्डर्स they would be in a better position to raise the next generation which will be more inclined towards, sensitive towards women issues?
Everything has to go, I think, hand in hand. Mm-hmm. Just giving property rights, like we can also talk about Panchayati Raj institutions, right? We have reservation. Mm-hmm. But we see reports that they are just dummies for the people. They are just dummies for men. Mm-hmm. Similarly, if they are given property rights, haan, us kuch had tak, it can, wo ek achha initiative hai. Lekin that's not the only initiative. Mm-hmm. All-round development was zaruri hai.
All-round development of women?
Of women, yeah.
And different, the government different angles. Should play a bigger role in this.
Exactly, through gender budgeting.
That I think should conclude the discussion here. Thank you.